PM question regarding last year. Meeting schedule. We increased meeting schedule until the start of camp.
Mm-hmm.
Right. And then we laid off and did like one, maybe one
summer, maybe.
One towards the middle or end of the summer.
Mm-hmm.
And then we met in the fall to recap and
mm-hmm.
start up that cycle.
Yeah, we're gonna need that because I believe I just saw something about budget needs to September, I believe.
September 15th.
Yeah, deadline. All right, so D just texted me and she's like, I'm really sorry, but I can't make it. So I'm kind of behind all of you guys. Did we have meeting minutes that were sent out or no?
No, we do not have meeting minutes.
Okay.
I have a set ready that needs to go out, but I've been working on grants
yes,
for the last month.
And you've been doing a fabulous job with that.
So, we're going to table minutes.
Okay, so we're going to table minutes.
Do you know the Wi-Fi password?
Yes.
it's
Rollinsford
yeah.
Police.
Okay.
Okay, but where there's an O, it's actually a zero.
Okay. Any capitals?
Rollinsford. R.
Yep.
And P.
Three. Okay.
Try that. It might work. Otherwise, you have to sort of putz around.
That for my notes. All right. So. Dee also sent me, so do we want, let's talk, she had a, we had an agenda, she wanted to approve meetings, we're going to, minutes, we're going to table that. Director, assistant director comments?
I'm more or less just needing what you guys need from me, because I'm kind of at a loss point right now, I'm not really sure what I'm missing and what needs to be done.
Okay.
So, I do have a couple things for you.
All right.
Homegrown Eats down at the mill has agreed to come in and do cheese making, do like a mozzarella class. But they need materials like milk and stuff. And Brandmore Farm has agreed to donate goods.
Yeah.
So I need to know, he said it's limited to like 15 kids at a time.
Okay.
If that's something you're interested in.
Do you know how long that process would take?
It would take like a morning, an hour or two.
For each 15?
I'm thinking. I can get in touch with, I can send you.
Yeah, everybody's info. Like,
yeah.
Because I don't have any drill bug info. I don't have info like that at all.
Yeah.
And I think you guys have all that. And I would like to get, I want to just get it done. So anything like that you can get me.
Yeah.
Kathy, have you reached out to, I know you did a couple of really great, so I don't know how much, you know, we're throwing at Brittany and Janessa and how much, like, we're doing at this point. So you had a couple people come in and do, you know, so are we stepping back from that and just letting you guys kind of run with it? Okay. So all you're looking for now is contacts. Okay. So anybody that you had last year, then maybe you can forward that on to Brittany. So what did, so you did the singing person, right?
I think I saw Taylor's number. I don't know if it's changed or not.
And then we had Kachiko.
Mm-hmm. Kachiko then.
Yep.
Yeah.
And then we had the ice cream making.
Mm-hmm.
And
was it Jibberbug that came in and did the glass?
Yeah.
But that we had to pay for. That wasn't like, we didn't pay for all that. That was volunteer stuff, right?
Yeah.
Kathy was working on the volunteer side of people coming in.
I think that was it. Was it?
I think so.
Because Taylor came in twice or once?
She only came in once.
Once.
You wanted to get her twice.
Twice, right.
It
did work out, right?
Yep.
And,
yeah. Yeah. So I just, so
Kachiko.
Kachiko,
yeah.
And,
well,
who did the ice cream?
I wasn't really sure about the ice cream because
yeah.
That's been planning.
Yeah.
So I didn't know if I wanted them to come.
I think
back.
All of our old young kids had a hard time doing it
yeah.
too.
Mm-hmm.
So well, maybe something like if we maybe that's something like just for older kids, like
team to do Friday morning.
Teen camp or something.
But even if I get their info and then we talk about it a little bit more.
Have you guys been working on other ideas for camp scheduling?
Or just
regular camp, yeah. Just kind of, like, are you throwing out an agenda like we tried to do last year, or are you?
Do you?
Which one?
Not the staff one. Yes. In short, yes.
Okay.
I have one for the parents so they know which activity the kids are doing when, and then I have a staff one with the specific activity for that time frame.
Yeah.
I'm going to do all of the all camp stuff Wednesday afternoons, just so it's all consistent and there's not a random one on a Thursday morning or something. Mm-hmm. But if that needs to change because things work more Wednesday mornings, I can do that. But I want it to be the same day, the same time each week.
Yeah.
So that's what we're looking at.
Yeah. Parents, right?
Yes.
I'm trying to make sure I
get
the whole thing.
So, like, the 1-2s have a certain color, 3-4s, 5-6s, or 5-up have a certain color. So it's easier for you to identify where that kid is at what time.
Okay. That's awesome.
So, I am in the process of writing grants right now.
Mm-hmm.
I have 2 grants out. And the 2 grants that are out, one would be for Doodlebugs to come in at least once, where I'm paying for twice.
Okay.
One to do glass and one to paint pottery.
No, don't worry.
And then, included in that would be rain day, $150 to go towards rain activities for the teen camp in case one of their activities get rained out.
Mm-hmm.
And in there was $250 to go to the Wentworth House.
Okay. And do you have a time for the Wentworth House? Or
no.
Okay.
Last year we were a little behind the 8-ball and didn't realize it until September that they had never been paid. So
okay.
Before I get you, I checked in with Caroline last week to make sure that they got paid last fall because I don't want us to go to them and ask them to do it again if they haven't been paid.
Exactly.
So they've been paid according to Caroline, and so I have a list of 4 people I need to get you information for.
Okay.
The Doodlebugs owner, Brand Moore, so we can reach out to them about materials for the homegrown eats thing. And see if that works with you guys. And then we'll let
Doodlebugs, Moore, Wentworth.
Brandmore, Wentworth.
Oh,
homegrown.
Homegrown.
Meats.
Oh, I have that one. Okay. Awesome. All right.
So those are 4 I have to get to you.
Okay.
Do you need help with the grant information, or is it everything being passed over?
Well, I've got, Kelly, what's next on the to-do list before I go off on that tangent?
Yeah, let's hold off on you for a second. So we want to, so director, so you guys are really, you're kind of doing the schedule.
I have one question.
Yeah.
For, like, the teen camp stuff and sending invoices and stuff for booking, I don't know who I'm sending that information to.
Mm-hmm.
I asked a little while ago.
Do you know
really
who needs up front? Do you know who?
Up front?
Yeah.
I know that's not technically needs up front, but they're letting me get away with it. And then I think Blitz needs up front.
Okay.
Not like the full, but like just a little thing.
So why don't we. And that, have you reached out to the other places, or have you?
Not
I know
all
most,
of them, because I started to, and they're like, well, we need to, like, do a deposit. I'm like, I can't do that. So.
Most of the time, I had looked up stuff all online.
Mm-hmm.
So the only person I had contacted was, like, the
but,
Sarah girl from Take Flight.
Yeah.
And did you talk to her about the full day
I
thing?
Haven't had a chance to.
Okay. So that, I think, probably should be, although, so I'm, and we can... Why don't we just talk about this for now? So right now, so Dee sent me numbers. So, right now we have a total of 33 people registered, and two of those are teen camp. So, we have pre-care is 12 and post-care is 6. So we have 33, and I guess if I'm reading this correctly, of the 33, two are teen camp, I guess that would be, but I don't know for what weeks either. So pre-care is 12 and post-care is 6.
So do you know if the 33 that are registered for Camp Raleigh are all 8 weeks or random weeks?
I don't know that. So here's our question is, okay, why? I have my own theories about why it's low. I think, personally, we didn't have a deadline for a discounted rate. I think, you know, people look at deadlines and they know they're saving money. That inspires them to register. Like, we have this open registration period. And closing is June 15th. So, you know, I haven't registered my kids yet. I put it on the back burner. I'm like, wait, how long do I have till?
That's why teens so well, though.
Mm-hmm.
Because a lot of them are waiting for your kids to register.
Well, yeah. And I've had a bunch of parents that have talked to me and said, what weeks are you doing with your kids? And I'm like, oh, I don't know. I haven't figured it out yet. I'm trying not to be nervous about numbers, but it's hard. It's hard.
Just be nervous. There's only 31 in Raleigh right now, even. Because
right.
I feel like at this point last summer there was so many more.
We had the May 15th early bird discounted rate, and that difficult to do it.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, right now there's no incentive. Like we have, you know, I got till June.
So I am
doing
June
15th,
like it.
Do you want to print it out? Like, you want to make it an early bird, you can say $20 if you do it June 1st?
I don't know if we could really change that right now. I mean, the problem, the reason that actually didn't happen this year is we couldn't do it on the website.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why.
And we gave them a savings. Instead of having an early bird registration, we gave them a savings within the whole summer.
Yeah.
So if you registered for the summer, it's by the week. You would save a chunk of money.
Yeah, but if you have more than one,
yeah,
like you, like she was saying, it's $550 right now.
So I have a question for the committee members. I brought this up in one of my emails about t-shirts to some of them. Kelly said she didn't register. Roxy, are you registered yet? I'm not registered. Are you registered?
He might be changing his mind about actually going. Yeah, I'm not registered.
So none of the...
Gabriel's going.
I know.
The very website is just not allowing me to register them without paying $500.
From the list you sent out with the t-shirts, I noticed that one or two of the other committee members had not registered yet.
And then Mercedes, of course, if there's like two kids in the teen camp, she's not going to go either. So I'm also stuck right now. I don't know what to do. Because she's older, and I don't want to force her to go somewhere, but there's nobody.
My older two will go, Ray and Shelby, but not every week, because they're doing other things too. So it's just a matter. That's why. That's what I haven't figured out.
There's 2 weeks that neither one of them will be there.
Right.
And I also met with Dee on Monday, and we talked about that last year. We put it out to the schools. We have not yet put it out to the schools. No flyer has gone home.
Nothing.
Yeah.
About Camp Raleigh.
That's what I was just talking about today.
So,
I don't know why.
Dee was going to get me the flyers, and I was going to take them over to the SAU tomorrow and see if they could get out to not only Rollinsford, but to Somersworth and Rollinsford.
I have a friend in Somersworth that wants to register her now.
But if I can take it to the SAU office, they'll send it right out through the whole school.
Mm-hmm. Was that through Marshwood?
No, Somersworth and Marshwood. And we talked that the teen camp flyer did. I think you
said I brought it over there, and I sent the hard copy to the principal, and I don't know why he hasn't forwarded it out to, and I'm a little bit bummed about that. So I don't know if maybe we could send the teen camp flyer to the SAU's office.
Copy of
you did through
just the regular rolling one. It's an SAU team forever, so if I had a good copy of it at school, that would be the easiest one to go.
Can I send it to you?
Yeah.
And you can get it out to the all the
paper
copy?
I can take it to SAU if you look busy.
I don't remember saying anything to
Tia.
The team camp flyer went through the school. I'm pretty sure I got one there.
I know that downstairs got a stack of teen flyers. I don't know what the teachers did with them. Yeah, I got one.
Oh, you did? So I don't remember seeing one in Tia's bag, but.
I think we didn't think of bright. So I can't find a page flyer, don't forget.
Yeah, if there's sort of like combined with the two of them, even.
Well, the first one, there was one that said teen or.
Yeah, or introducing,
right?
I think, yeah, teen camp or something.
It was
like
on
that.
The
yeah.
Camp Raleigh page or something like that.
I know that the, I'll find it.
This is nothing going to put out on the Facebook page, right?
I've put it out a few times.
Well, that's the, that one's like,
that was the
highlights just teen. There's not a lot of them.
But just regular
just
camp?
Just regular Raleigh on that one.
Yeah, I haven't, honestly, I haven't kind of worried about Camp Raleigh, because
yeah.
I thought, we had 75 people last year. I figured
mm-hmm.
we would have more this year.
I haven't gotten out either as much putting the flyers out in businesses yet either.
Maybe
I mean,
another one home with the kids.
Yeah. I can put some out too if you give me, if you let me know.
It's on my to-do list right now for the Camp Raleigh flyers. Brittany for RGS
mm-hmm.
sent it to the committee and determine where people are putting it.
I work at like Dover Centennial City, right in the downtown. So
oh, I can put one in that.
Yeah,
district.
While I'm there, I mean, I can just hit all of that strip of stores. So just let me know.
Which were you with?
Dover Centennial City.
Okay.
So I mean, just
yeah.
that like strip. I mean, I work next to Shaw's, like all that, right there. So, and then there's a lot of foot traffic during the day. So.
Can we put some at the post office?
There's a teen camp one up there right now.
There's a teen camp one at the library too. The library post office and the Camp Raleigh one at the library too.
And then can we put them so people can make?
I left a stack at the library.
Mm-hmm.
So but I was thinking like the Elliott Library, they have a whole book of summer camps. And then they have our teen camp flyer, but they don't have our Camp Raleigh flyer.
Did they have do we have a one-page thing for Camp Raleigh that we sent home with the kid, like the kids that volunteered yet?
No, that's what I need to get to Brittany.
Yeah.
And actually, this is it for this year in a full page.
Does that say the teen camp as well?
This is the
teen camp has its own.
Yeah,
it has
this
schedule on it.
This one is a little screwed up, but
that's essentially
that's the same thing. It's
yeah,
just missing a word at the top.
That, but I wonder.
Well, this says a little type. This is that unless my eyes are really bad, does that say grades 1 through 8?
It does. She left it grades 1 through 8.
Okay.
So,
it's very cute. I think it needs to. Yeah, we definitely need to make some copies.
So I have that. And it might even be on the drive, so I can send that out.
Can you make copies of that at school?
Yeah, that's why I asked her if I had teen.
What
yeah.
was the big stack that was here?
That was all teen.
Oh, it was?
Yeah.
Okay. And from what I read on the Marshwood sites, it was going off to the teachers, or the principals at the different schools, that they might send it home. It's up to the individual principals at the Marshwood schools.
Yeah, well, I sent the middle school one.
I have a teacher friend at the Great Works, so I can try and see if that's the, what was it, fourth and fifth?
Fourth and
fifth.
Fourth
and fifth,
yeah.
Yeah, so I can try and see if I can talk to her too.
It would be good if it went out to the middle school. I brought a stack over to the middle school,
mm-hmm.
so it's there for taking, but, you know, I can go to it, and then a family friend of ours today, and their kids aren't going to go. And I just said, you know, can I ask you, you know, why? And she said, well, you know, and it was our basic back and forth discussion. They don't really need a babysitter, you know, and we can't really afford it. So, you know, my thought, if we can get, and I don't know, maybe this will put the big kibosh on this if this doesn't do anything this summer, I don't know. But my thought is if we can somehow, and I know the price is low, but it's not low enough, is somehow get that, our transportation cost. Like if we could do a grant, I think I talked to you about that when I saw you, if we could do a grant to cover that transportation cost, that would be so ideal to remove that from the equation, and then we're just charging them, you know.
It, for me, it's really expensive.
Yeah.
And I'm like, ugh.
Yeah.
You know, I was waiting to see if I was going to have a book bag, you know, if I was going to send them. I can't believe it. I don't know if I can send my kids, you know.
Yeah.
I look at it as $170 a week, and that is a lot of money.
Yeah.
I mean, mm-hmm. I haven't paid daycare like that in a long time, but I do
want
her to go. I will figure it out, but.
The awesome part about the team camp is that you get to go places,
mm-hmm.
but the only places is
yeah.
expensive.
Yeah.
So it's like
oh, it
even the top, like their minimum group size number is 20.
Mm-hmm. Right, so if we're less than that, then we're not getting any discounted rate.
Right. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm working with Hilltop.
Yeah.
It's Hilltop, but everywhere else I'm running into that. Like our group rates are this, but I'm like, I'm not a full group. What can you do? Like,
right.
You don't even know
how many.
Right.
Right.
Well, it's hard to book anything.
Probably
you don't even
kids.
Know.
Right.
What we were guessing.
Right. We're open.
You know, right.
15 to 20. Right. So, I don't know. So, if we can try and get, you know, my feeling is we can, any connections that we all have to.
And the select board, one of the select board members asked Dee and I, because we met out in front, what the numbers look like this year. We said, we're a little slow compared to last year.
But I, yeah, like I said, I'm not as worried about Camp Raleigh. I think that'll be fine. I think people are just waiting.
Mm-hmm.
And I know some people are really waiting on the teen camp to figure it out with their friends, you know.
Yeah, and like I said, the one parent that said if he could go to Camp Raleigh the other 2 days, then he would go to teen camp. But since he can't, he just has to go to Camp Raleigh.
Mm-hmm.
So,
right.
So, Brittany, to get back to your question about the teen camp, have you reserved
invoices and deposits and stuff? I think I can convince all of them to send invoices. I just need to know who to send it to.
You need to get an invoice, and then you need to have them send it to you.
Okay.
And then you need to come here and get a purchase order.
And what are town hours?
I don't
know.
9 to 1. Every day except for Thursday. And then Thursdays, 3 to 7.
I mean, you can always let me know too, and I can do.
And then what you basically do is it says at the top who's requesting the money.
Mm-hmm.
So you would put like.
The rent committee?
No, you would put who you're sending the money to.
Oh,
so,
okay. So
like Blitz or Hilltop.
Okay.
And then it'll say quantity, you know, put like 15 passes, day passes for Camp Raleigh, teen
mm-hmm.
camp. And then you put your total, it'll be cost per person, and then your total cost.
Mm-hmm.
And at the bottom, you can put like deposit of
okay.
like down. And then total cost, and then the select board has to approve it.
Oh, okay. What do I do if they don't? What are we gonna do?
They're
a contingency plan.
I think their main objective is to make sure that they know
okay.
we're spending money, and
okay.
they want to make sure we're staying within our budget. And
okay.
those will be the questions they'll ask.
Oh, we have another question. Okay, that makes sense. For Blitz. They jump by the hour, so how long were we projecting? Because it gets pricey, the longer
for a group, too?
Yeah.
I thought we've always done with them. What, because we went with them to the, with the regular camp last year.
Yeah.
Well, isn't that a $20 fee?
No, we didn't go last year because, wait, or did we go last year?
Birthday parties there for $20 a kid for
right
10 kids, right?
You only get an hour at camp time.
Yeah.
And then
yeah.
You get an hour in the party room.
Mm-hmm.
And see you later.
And then there's the cost of like socks too, that kids don't have those too.
Mm-hmm.
But so I wonder if we should plan a birthday party.
Which it would be fine. I'm just wondering what you would want me to do with them for the rest of the day.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because that doesn't fill their day.
Well, I figured from there, like, they have full access to this bus, right? You can take those kids right from Blitz and go to Wall of Sands or
okay.
Yeah, they'll be real hot
from
jumping.
Or,
yeah.
Yeah.
I'm just wondering some
too.
Suggestions to give to Katie. So
yeah.
That's all
yeah.
It's important.
Kids get nice and sweaty on my turn.
Okay.
And
yeah.
That actually leads me into one of my questions that I brought with me, is that I'm applying for a couple more grants. So Blitz or something to offset some of the teen camps would be
probably good.
Yeah, because I know on some of the bigger things like the Canopy Lake, I think was 20 kids or
yeah.
25, and then the one in Saco was
Fun Town,
you might have needed
25
campers.
Yeah.
For what?
For
their group
rate.
Which is not, like significant.
With the group rates?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Do you want to
Google it? Yeah, if you
want to
Google it,
I'll
put something
else up. It might have been $5 a kid. I don't know if it was.
Do they have any plays at Garrison that take the kids and they're inside that day?
I haven't looked.
I mean, I think that the select board would probably wouldn't be a car, like a lot of cars.
Even talking to Katie about that kind of stuff, like, you know, if it's, you know, she can do whatever, maybe we'll have to contact her, like, okay, if you're here for 2 hours, then where are you going next?
Right.
You know, have a second, you know, lunch spot, you know, they need a lunch spot, and then.
I've just been researching.
I looked at Clubhouse Kids. And when they didn't have something to fill the day, they would do, like, Hilltop Fun Center and Dairy Queen. So then they would go to Ice Cream After.
Mm-hmm.
Or, so, like, maybe they go to Blitz and then they go to the Beach Plum or something like that.
Yeah.
And get ice cream. And they can bring their own money.
Yeah.
To get ice cream.
Yeah.
And then head to
but then,
Newcastle.
Yeah. That's just starting to get a little pricey for upfront money for them, too,
yeah.
As well.
Yeah.
But, again, that's something Katie and I can talk about for extras for those days. Because Hilltop, the longest group is 4 hours. Could probably get them to stretch it. Price might increase a little bit.
But.
Too bad
we're not going
there.
Too bad we couldn't go there and then.
Wait, they're still in school.
Ow.
Fucker. It says for the combination water park and rides for 25 to 99 people, it's $27. Unless we go after 3 p.m., then it's $18.
What are you talking about now?
Flattown, Splashdown.
So I think we were not gonna do, yeah, I think we were
just Splashdown?
Yeah.
$20. But that's when you get to 25 people.
What is it less than 25?
When it's not 25 people, you have to pay per day. And
Garrison Players is doing Grease and High School Musical this summer. But I think they're all night shows.
Yeah.
Bummer.
48 inches and taller is $30.
Yeah. Sorry, you're not allowed.
You're stuck here.
Don't move.
I believe in.
You should be
about it's too late. I asked her about the fundraiser thing. He keeps.
How about staffing?
His name is Steve. Steve at Newix.com.
It's about the having people go in on a night and then they donate 10%. Kathy, do you have more than one of those on in front of your face? I'm going to send this to the SAU's office. I'm going to send it to Mary to say, hey, could you distribute this?
Do you want me to forward you a copy that says introducing instead of a gov with gov at the top?
Oh, that's funny. What was on the hard copy or on the email copy, do you know?
It's the same thing.
Okay.
I might actually have another copy of it. I don't know.
No, it's fine. I have it was sent to me from Jody, maybe on email, so that's all I wanted. Yeah, I'm gonna send that to the
Elliot has her own rec program, so that might be
and software sends their kids to Clubhouse Kids and stuff.
Yeah.
But my problem with that is, like, we're a part of their school system now, so
definitely.
They shouldn't be
ostracized.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I totally get it. Yeah, I'm just saying that might be.
I think I'm sure that's what it is.
So here probably is not my middle name, Brian's.
No, it's not. It's up till 12 years of age.
Which is about 8th grade. Unless you've got some older kids. Because generally people...
It's just weird to think about Shelby.
Or 7th grade.
Because Shelby's 13 and she's in 7th grade, so...
Yeah, she's old.
Yeah.
For her grade.
So a lot. So the 7th graders right now are turning 13.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I see.
So, so it would be 1 through 6, definitely.
Mm-hmm. 7th is questionable.
Yeah, yeah.
But
so basically covers everybody in Rollins, grade school.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
And then there's an option on the 12-year-olds, whether they want to choose one or the other. They can do that.
Does Caroline put this on the school website yet?
I do not.
On the school Facebook page?
I don't know. I don't use Facebook all that often, so I really don't know what's on there. What is it? Are you on the school Facebook?
No, but I can ask my mom.
Okay. You had a question about staff.
Yeah. How are we for that? I mean, is we have everybody back from last year, correct?
Yeah, besides Jada. But
right.
I called the girl back and said yes,
yep.
That I needed her. Do I call Marshall with how the numbers are right now?
Should we join this in non-public if we're talking means?
Oh,
no.
Sorry.
No.
Should I call the gentleman back?
So did she accept?
Yeah.
Okay. So how many?
I just don't have the.
How many counselors does that give us?
That would be.
We have you two.
But are we considered counselors?
No.
Okay.
So besides you two, that's why I wanted the number without you two.
Possibly 9. Possibly 10, not counting teen assistant. Unless you want to count her.
Don't count her.
Okay, so 10 possibly.
And are all those full-time?
No. You're,
yeah.
And then he would also be part.
MS?
Yes.
Okay.
And then
do we need another part-time?
Well, the other one would be for teen. No, I don't think we need another part-time for Raleigh. The other one in question would be for teen.
Are you talking about the one that I just told you about recently?
Yes.
Did she send in an application?
I haven't gotten anything
from
her yet.
Okay. So what about, didn't you interview two people last time?
And that's the girl that I called back in grade.
Okay,
and then
so
it was
she's
MS
in. Okay.
That I haven't called back yet. I think he tried calling me, but didn't leave a message.
Yeah.
I didn't answer. I officially called him.
So maybe if we had the same numbers as we had last year,
would you need him? Yes.
And how many, you said 2 part-time and 8 full-time?
Well, the teen counselor would technically be part-time because there's only 3 days.
So 10 currently for Camp Raleigh, right?
No,
10
1
total.
2, 3, 4, 5, wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 for Raleigh. And 2 of those are part-time. So 7 full.
One for teen, the assistant, and then the one part-time counselor.
Right? Yep.
Okay.
Okay, and then if we need that, I don't know what, we haven't heard from her anyway, right?
From the, no.
Okay.
I've not heard from JF.
Yeah. Okay. and MS would be full-time, yes?
Part.
Did he, that's what he
mm-hmm.
said?
Because he, well, I kind of asked slash led him that way because he would need certain Mondays and Fridays off for baseball.
I've also talked to his mom about it just because my sister, his sister.
Yep.
And she suggested that that would be the better option, again, because he needs
mm-hmm.
those, some of those weekends.
So maybe you go ahead and
do it. Okay. That was going to be my question, just based on numbers.
I think so, and then that, I mean, you can definitely tell him, right now we're unsure of how many hours we'll be needing him, but officially, but you know, as I assume you have a bunch of counselors that have vacation time and things like that, right?
There's one very stressful week that everybody needs off.
Which
it's
one is that?
The week that I'm also gone. It's July 9th to the 16th.
It's the week right after
16th is like how long I'm gone for.
Yeah.
It's
the week after 4th of July.
Yeah, it's, let me just put the exact dates. Yeah, 9th to the 13th. There's myself.
Yeah, I was thinking about signing myself that week, but I might go next week.
Potentially four.
Yeah, potentially four. Three for sure. One that asked or finally replied later than all the others, so I told them it wasn't a guarantee. But technically, we have four asking for time off that 1 week.
Hmm. So yeah, so why don't you go ahead and do that?
Okay. Sounds good.
So then that means we can send out dates.
Yes. Would you like the dates that we have for training? Just so you guys are in the loop with that. We haven't sent it out yet.
Sure.
So CPR and first aid. Actually, let's go chronological.
So Sunday, June 10th.
And I'll just be at the school. I'll come to my classroom for the day.
We're trying to, I know last year we split it up into 2 days.
Yep.
This year we want to do one.
Yeah.
So we're just going to plan out Sunday, June 10th.
So that's not the CPR.
No.
You backed up.
Yeah.
So Sunday, June 10th is just a training. And then Monday, June 18th is CPR and first aid.
That's at the school. That's piggybacking off of them. I gave them approximately, we probably have about 10. So she's trying to get me numbers for that, so I can give that to you guys.
And did they have to pay for that, or are you guys paying for it?
We.
Yeah.
We didn't budget it last year, but it is in our budget.
Mm-hmm. I remember talking to you. Mm-hmm.
So that's on the 18th, and that's at the school, that's when
yep.
they do the teachers and
yeah.
stuff like that?
That's
okay.
Everybody. Okay.
So, and everybody who did one last year,
just
right? Because it's a 2 year, right? It's a 2 year thing.
Yeah.
So that'll
so,
work out well.
Yeah.
We. For first aid and CPR, we have budgeted $300.
Okay.
What are they charging this time, Brittany? Do you know?
I would that she was getting me the numbers.
Okay.
I don't have that yet. And I'm sorry.
I don't remember what it was last year.
$300?
$300.
Yeah. Right, thank you. It shouldn't be any more than that, but.
Wasn't it 20 for them?
There was something
like $20, right? Okay, any other dates there? They're out of school that day. They're already out, you guys are out of school, right?
No, that's a workshop day.
Okay.
Oh.
The kids are out.
Oh,
it's
I
a
forgot.
Workshop day.
I
got two of them now.
I'm thinking summer's work because they don't get out until the 22nd.
Wow.
Yeah.
We don't have summer work.
No.
He'll be done.
Yeah, he'll be done.
Any other, what about, what do you know about building usage and?
Last update was gym, teacher's room, art room.
Teacher's room.
Mm-hmm. No stage, so we have the full art room, which has a sink and everything for doodles. However, you and I might have some a lot of work to do the weekend before.
Gym, the gym office room?
The teacher's room?
The gym, art room, and what was the
teacher's room? With
yeah,
the fridge and the stove.
I went gym, teacher's room.
Which one?
So I'm like, there's a gym, teacher's room?
Well, I mean, yes, there's that office, but that's not the one we have.
Well, that's going to be tricky.
Why?
Because I may not be in town.
help setting?
I might be help setting up slash clearing out the art room because that particular teacher takes a long time to do it, which is fine. Like, I get it, there's a lot of stuff in there, but if we're moving in, I gotta help her do that a little faster.
But do you think this year there'll be that kind of, I mean, she's got a full week to do that.
Exactly. She's got a week to procrastinate.
Uh-huh.
However, she could just get it all done. I don't know.
Yeah.
This is just what I've heard from teachers in the past. And she also has to move her entire room now. So, again. The other thing was...
Is she moving back into that room, or is she going to a different space afterwards, you know?
I have no idea where she's moving
okay.
to.
Okay. Just curious.
Yeah, I haven't gotten the building layout for that yet.
So what was the update date that you might need help?
That would be before, so the 23rd would be my goal, just because there's a dancer center that I'd like to go to on Sunday, but if I can't, it's fine.
What is that?
23rd of June. It's a Saturday.
I'm Sydney Maine for a softball tournament.
Yeah. My mom's off at home anyway, so it's okay.
We can
and,
also
yeah, come and help with some.
Put you down for counselors too.
Yeah,
yeah.
As a training.
Training.
Do it.
Yeah. The first week of team camp, she's still in school.
Did she talk about Wednesday, do you know? Did she?
She didn't tell me anything about Wednesday. She wasn't sure about Wednesday. My mom, however, has offered to help Monday.
Oh.
And then if I have to do Wednesday, that's fine, because we've kind of talked about that.
Okay.
Is that something the committee would be okay with? She is a teacher at the school. She knows the kids.
Yes.
I mean, just to help us out so I'm not gone the first day of camp, because that would stress me out.
Right. I don't see a problem with that at
okay.
all. Let me...
Yeah.
I'll
no.
talk to Dee
right
about
five.
This. Actually,
yeah.
Dee and I are going to meet on Wednesday.
And
yeah,
actually,
so.
We can't make that decision because
yeah.
we don't have a quorum anymore.
Oh, okay.
So we can take it under advisement and let you
know.
We've not heard
of
school. Only
right.
Yes. And then that would be, and the second part of that is kind of up in the air too, right? But,
yeah. I mean, if they have to come back and do stuff at camp, I don't care. We can find space for that kind of stuff.
Well,
but I know what the appeal,
the
right. And the appeal is not being there
right.
with all the little kids.
Right.
I expressed my opinion on how that would be just because I think for myself it's new to me this year, so
having her not have to be alone on day one would be
ideal.
But
well, and I also wonder like I could probably do that day
yeah.
too.
Mm-hmm. I just know you all have full time, like
right.
you guys don't get summers off like the rest of us. So
and I could. Work out that day too, because my son will be in Camp Raleigh.
Mm-hmm.
So if you need an extra pair of pants, I can give up a little.
Well, and that honestly really depends.
Numbers,
mm-hmm.
what's needed.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, and actually Friday I can come in.
And it almost sounds like unfortunately.
It sounds
like
she's
won't know
done
until, like,
Wednesday.
June 15th,
so her Friday will
need.
Be okay.
Like,
it's just those first two.
That's
okay.
kind of scary. I don't
yeah.
think I like our deadline.
Like that's 10 days before camp starts.
Right. Which
you weren't here last year.
I know.
You don't.
I know.
Shh.
Do they have an ice cream service board anymore?
Oh, that was supposed to
PTO.
Be today.
No
PTO never.
It
we
got
followed.
Canceled.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, I never followed through with it. It was supposed to be today.
Hmm. Wow. Oh. That's really a big sign up day.
Yeah,
I remember doing this mortgage
board.
Yeah,
it
was.
I went for the ice cream.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Your parents would sign you up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Only the messages that you've seen.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
approve it. Since, yeah, we can defeat that. My understanding, although I haven't heard yet from anybody at the PTO, but the calendar sales, I believe, were roughly around what Carolyn had said was around $1,600. So,
oh, yeah.
Yeah. So if we, in fact, get half of that.
I'm not going to say that we're going to get about
right,
that.
Right, I know.
They have to take out what they
spent right,
to fill up the calendars.
Right. So, I mean, so that might be something.
But I did. We are, Kelly and I are in a group Facebook chat with the PTO staff trying to get answers. And try to find out. I offered for them to come tonight and speak to us.
Yeah.
They weren't able to come. I offered to share information about the calendar. They were able to get it for me. I haven't heard anything. Their meeting was supposed to be May 8th, and it got canceled.
Yeah. Sorry. Okay.
And somebody, as Kelly knows, somebody emailed me or Facebooked me a message that they wanted to buy a calendar, and I didn't get it until after the calendar sales had started. So I reached out to both groups to say, what information do you want me to give this person if they want to make a donation?
Mm-hmm.
I heard from Kelly.
Send him to me.
So I just been responding to him. Haven't heard anything.
Yeah.
And so
I'll try to be a little more proactive with that. Like, give me that one. I'll take that one on.
Did you want craft supplies donated again this year?
Yes. So the general idea is each group's gonna have crafts 3 times a week. Two of them are gonna match the theme of the week, and then one of them's just a generalized camp activity. So if I'm remembering what we have in the shed correctly, we'll be okay. I want glitter and stuff like that.
Glitter.
Pony beads. Okay, send it to me. I want to do pony bead keychain things because nobody does those anymore. But I think it'd be fun for those off arts and crafts days. So.
Can you send me a list of what you're looking for arts and crafts and
okay.
from a grocery
and
store? Because if I go to Hannaford's or Target and get gift cards, I know I can probably buy you your inflatable pools that you're looking for.
Mm-hmm.
But other smaller items,
right?
Okay. I can get to.
That was my question. Are we doing snack again this year?
Yes.
Are we looking for?
We're doing the cart thing.
Are we doing donations?
Yes.
Okay. Because Mr. I and a couple of other teachers have asked me about it. So
yeah.
I know a lot of the teachers are looking or wanting to donate stuff.
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. I mean, Mr. I's always really good.
Yeah, Mr. I's always ready.
But, yeah. So I'll let him know once he's in the list.
Yeah, I think so. Maybe.
So we can
do
this list.
So
we
can
give
you
the
cards.
You did not.
Okay.
So
finish
on
this.
Whatever really
you have the game
you
part,
but
you have the
game.
And I have
a
ton of lists going. So we can either give them or we can go do it ourselves.
Uh-huh.
And whatever.
I think if you two are in school and you know what you want, and if there's people that are willing, I mean, so, you know, this is kind of more where you knew what we sold last year. I mean, you want to be sort of on the healthy side of things, right? So, yeah.
That was very hard. Because a lot of the times, we got a lot of, Apple donations, but
the kids don't want
apples.
If they're there and there's no parent telling them, oh no, you should buy the apple, they're going to buy all the ice pops in my freezer.
Yeah.
Or the pudding.
Freeze pops were a big thing last year. We were constantly running out of them.
Yeah.
And then there's another thing too. We did bread with peanut butter and jelly last year, but we don't use it as often.
Yeah.
And that bread went bad so quickly, and I
feel like a lot of those times we were just wasting a lot of food.
Yeah.
So that's another thing that's hard too.
So it's more like granola bars and
yeah.
So you guys would know
kind of
yeah.
the best sellers of stuff. And I don't know, I mean I guess my feeling is just go with that.
But I can add that to this list for like
and
shops
I
and
have
stuff.
We can only be so wonderful.
I have a list.
I think being wonderful of doing healthy snacks is the best idea, but in reality those kids want nothing to do with healthy
yeah.
food.
I know, if you guys had ring bombs in there, my boys would be like, why?
I would never sell those to your children because they would run around with them in your mouth.
Oh, yeah. A lot of
they would just
be
like, so,
yes,
yeah.
Last year, we had a postcard that went with the flyers requesting donations so that businesses could give donations to, and I will send that to you. You guys can look it over. It was like potato chips and freeze pops and granola bars and peanut butter crackers and stuff like that. And some of it was sporting equipment.
Mm-hmm.
I will send it to Brittany and Kate.
Okay. Now that we cleaned that shed out and we have everything like organized, it's going to be a little bit organized.
Not very organized.
The put away process is not handled. No, you weren't.
Okay, what's next on your agenda?
We need to make that up. Maybe that is just as important as setup day as closed down.
Why?
I'm always on vacation anyways.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I'm always on vacation last week again.
I could be there.
Oh, actually, that's not true. I don't
closing
think this week.
Down would have been fine had the direction of the proper person had been there.
All right, so Celia, we're kind of like camper registration update. I gave that sponsorship donation update.
Okay, yeah, that would be me. So, go.
No.
You can look at this. We'll pass it around.
Okay,
the
there's no breaks.
I
think what can we give you to do? I want to give you something to do.
She has something to do. She has to send me contacts.
So,
not that many, though.
We applied to get this is the application. Yeah, you can look at it. They will be letting us know by August 1st, 2018, whether or not we get anything from them. Because they take 90 days, to 60 to 90 days, to look up other things. The select board has already given us their okay, and if we get anything, the select board has to sign it. That's just to tell us the date they're going to respond by. And they also have a program called Fundraising for Dollars, and we would, for $5, print out a coupon book and sell it for $10. And this is the information on Fundraising for Dollars. If that is something we want to consider down the line. We don't have to.
So what is it? So let's just back up. Fundraising for Dollars account. Place an order by the coupon book. So this would be, we would have to sell coupon books. Is that what it is?
We buy them for $5 and we sell them for $10.
So maybe we should think about this for next year if we don't want to do the calendar again or we want to try this.
Yeah.
Maybe we table that for next year's kind of.
That's Dick.
Oh, this is Dick. Okay.
That's the, we put in a grant. And
$5 for
that's the
Dick's
one for $500 worth of equipment. Including your footballs, your flag football, your pennies, soccer bowls, nets.
But the problem with that is we wouldn't get there till when?
August 1st.
Right?
August 1st is when
they I'm thinking awesome for next summer.
Yes, that's what the last line says. Since this is coming at the end of our season, we'll be able to replace anything that is damaged.
And I'll talk to the facilities manager and the PE teacher about using the schools for this summer.
So this is pretty good. The coupons are pretty good. I'd buy that for $5.
Well, we buy, the committee buys it for $5 and then sell them for $10.
Oh.
And we would get any money left over. So I also applied to Eastern Bank, and it is a... This is the packet on the back. Eastern Bank, if they, we have asked for a minimum of $1,000, which would cover Doodlebugs coming in once for glass fusing, and 200 or 250 to go to the Wentworth House. However, we said we could go up to as much as 2,000, which would be another $800 to bring Doodlebugs back in to paint pottery, and an extra 150 to 200 for the teen camp for rainy day activities.
Okay.
So like going to the movies or something that's too expensive. So those two, that one we said 30 days to 60 days. So we'll know mid-June to mid-July whether or not we get those. I already talked to Doodlebugs and let them know that they're contingent on us getting the grant money. But you would be reaching out to them. We have two more grants coming in to apply for. And Kelly,
yes.
When these are done, I need you to keep them because you and Dee need to read them as soon as possible and get them to the select board.
Okay. Like, so are they done, like, as of now, or?
Pretty much. So.
I'm meeting with Dee on Wednesday.
So I'm going to take them to the select board tomorrow, because these are due June 1st. The select board is not going to meet again before June 1st. But the new fundraising one. It says nonprofit. I've already been in contact with them. They will donate to municipal agencies. They do fire departments, police departments, and I know Dee wrote something about wanting the STEM guy to come in from the UNH. So this grant is asking for $500 for him to come in.
I was going to ask what his price was.
It's $50 every hour. Plus materials. And there's a price list on here.
Can I tell you something real quick? We have a contact at the shipyard STEM for free. They have community outreach. So we can talk to them. I'm not putting a kibosh on anything, I'm just saying it's free and it's an educational thing. We can ask them.
Do you know, is it the same thing or is it a different? I'm just wondering.
Yeah.
If you know.
I don't know, like, how much she's offering, you know, how involved it is for the kids.
So
do you have a contact
at the shipyard?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can we give you that assignment to reach
yeah.
out?
Yeah. And then
let us know.
His name is Ed Cormier. I can give you his information.
Yeah.
I can email it to you. But did you want to talk to him and see
yeah.
what the details?
And
so
see
you can compare
what the different ones are.
See if it's, he's going to save money.
Do you know if he does the one at the South Berwick Library?
I don't. I know that he does it at Elliott. He goes in with several engineers from the shipyard and does.
Because I know South Berwick does it STEM night once a month.
Have you
okay.
gotten the passes for the parks yet? For the state parks?
They are in.
Okay.
I don't have them in my possession. I
no, that's
Caroline
okay.
has
that's
them.
Okay.
Yes,
just,
they are in.
Okay.
Yep.
No, Caroline doesn't.
There are two Carolines.
There's
a Caroline here, yeah, and there's
I
a Caroline at the school.
Got to draw a line.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, do we want to submit this grant with the STEM, or do we want to, with the STEM programs? I said $500. Let me see. So, it asks for a history and everything. So, to bring STEM in for the older kids, we would like to take advantage of a local university student who has approached us. His programs are geared towards grades 4 through 10 that overlap our two programs. We would like to have him come in twice on two different days at a cost of $150 per visit, totaling $300 for both visits. In each hour, he would take
10 to 15 students. Therefore, he would have to repeat the same one a couple of times. And then the remaining $200 that we're asking for would cover his materials and travel costs, because some of the material costs are up to $70. And then, since that doesn't cover the 1 through 4, I said that we would like to bring in, and I've been in contact with the Mount Washington Observatory out of North Conway.
Okay.
And they'll come down for $275 and do a program through here. I haven't committed to anything, but we would have to coordinate with another local agency for them to come down just for us. Otherwise, it's going to be $450. So if we ask for $500, they could come down and do two presentations to 30 kids at once. And they provide programs K through 12. So that is what this one is about. And so I'm just going to change this. And then, so this is what we're requesting. They are requesting, though, that we tell them, we have to give them a board of directors and our background information. So,
the select board?
No, of the committee. Like, because we're the ones that were working on this program. And the select board's like our financial department.
Okay.
So I put down stuff I knew for everybody except for Liberty.
I'm married.
And that's for the Washington.
This is for what?
Trying to get my attention.
This is for the grant.
Okay.
To bring in the money. They want to know that the people that are on the board overseeing this are qualified to do it. So, like, Kelly, I put down that you're a parent and a swim coach and an avid athlete. And so all of us are parents, but I wasn't sure. And I put, like, relevant sporting and teaching experiences that we all had, budget committee members, stuff like that. So I wasn't sure what to put down for you.
Okay.
You're right there. And then for Kathy.
Jack Bob trades really what I am.
I was going to put something down about, like, working with senior citizens or something like that.
Hair.
How many times can you come? We like to come lots of times. Mm-hmm. It's great. It's educational. And, like, at Elliott, and you guys are great.
Okay.
You know, so it's a science thing, but technical and educational.
Yeah.
So I would say go forward with both of these things and
see if one pans out.
Yeah.
And if we don't get this grant, then we don't have to. And as I found out from Eastern Bank, they don't require follow-up. They mandate you use the money as you say you're going to use it.
Well,
so if we have to change plans, then maybe we have somebody else come in and do STEM activities instead. And we use it
for something else.
For that. We want to be as true to our word as possible. So that is that one. You can pass it around. And
so what do I have to approve? Which one? That one? Do you want me to take that? Is that my copy? Because I'm going to see Dia Wednesday.
Dia Wednesday.
So
I have work, or I'd come join you.
And I'm going to pass that down to Kathy.
On Wednesday?
1 o'clock.
So the other one I put application in for is Optima Bank. I'm waiting to hear back from them whether or not we qualify. But they're out of Portsmouth, and for them, I'm asking for $1,000, which would be $800 to bring doodlebugs in. So if we don't have the Eastern Bank grant, we can still bring in doodlebugs. And if the Eastern Bank grant comes through, then she can come in and have them make clay pots, fire them, and then they can paint them the next week. And then $200 to either go to the Wentworth House, if the Eastern Bay doesn't come through, or to bring in Seacoast Science Center, traveling aquatic animals. That would be awesome.
That is the thing that was at the
Is that the Woodman Park thing?
Yeah.
Woodman.
That's the same
and
thing,
so,
but they come to us at Woodman.
I haven't heard that that's coming back to Woodman Park.
I haven't seen anything either. I looked it up the other day because I was trying to see if it fit into Mermaid Week or not. But
yes, so, I said that our which program we picked would depend on our theme. And so there are 4 or 5 here that you could look at. And I can email that to you.
Yes, please.
But that is that. That's my grant.
Darren, I got cop jobs. You want one?
I got a pocket full.
Right there. That one. I've been forwarding everything I get from my Yahoo back to that one. So.
Which guy?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Where was he?
I don't have the information on my
butt. The skateboarding dude?
Yeah. And we can up that one to $1,500 if you want, and because that's originally what I wrote it for.
Yeah.
And add in the skateboarding dude.
Yeah, let's do that.
He sounded so good.
Yes, he did.
He sounded very young.
And I know my twins would love that.
Yeah.
A skateboarding dude.
Mm-hmm.
Is this mine? Okay, Liberty, do you want to look at this? But yeah, I would put that up to 1,500 there. So let's do.
So
what am I supposed to do with this 50?
Review.
Yeah, I'm going 1,500 on that one. Can we find that name? Right? I might have that.
It's Chris.
I was kind of hoping that Dan would be here to make sure it's all technically correct.
You've done a lot of work.
So this is why my minutes are not up. So, we also, last year, I requested the Strawberry Festival out of South Berwick.
Yeah, that's in June.
The last weekend in June.
Yeah.
I will not be here. It's June 30th. They have space for South Berwick, Elliott, and Rollinsford organizations with nonprofit status. And so I need to confirm with them that we can be part of them because their letter says that we cannot be getting help from the town. But we would also have to confirm, in order to get a grant from them, our forms have to be in by June 5th.
Is this for the strawberry? What is your thought with that? That we would have a tent of some sort, or
to get a grant through them, they need volunteers. So I have information here that we have to fill out. With our organization, the contact person, address, phone number, email, nonprofit status number, tax ID, and whether or not we're going to do food or children's games. First choice and second choice. Do we want to do food or children's games?
So this is at the Strawberry Festival.
We have to participate by providing volunteers.
Yeah.
In order to get a grant. We accept application for projects funding requests of $100 to $1,000, and it must be for a complete project or proof of matching funds to complete the project. So that's, and it must be done within 9 months of the receipt, and we would find out the week camp starts whether or not we got this.
So we would have to do a children's game or what?
Or food, like dish out strawberries.
Oh, yeah. I've heard about this. Mm-hmm. The lady that's in charge of this is with me on the ladies' auxiliary.
So
she doesn't have any help. She needs help.
So this would be doing doing the shortcake or selling that?
Getting it out. We wouldn't keep the money. We would hand it out. We would dish it out.
You would dish up the strawberry shortcake, you would pull strawberries a couple days.
Pull strawberries is a couple days before.
Yeah. Or run a children's game out in the back on the playground.
It'd be better to be under the tent.
not nonprofit status.
Yeah. Any help from the town.
Right.
But
so,
if you know any teenagers that need volunteer hours, because I guess in Marshwood,
mm-hmm.
you have to have volunteer hours, they need strawberry hullers. They really need those really bad. And
they
need volunteers to do all that stuff.
So we can.
They really need people to do that.
That's not good.
You don't even know my life.
So I will pass this around. People feel free to look at it, but I'm not sure we qualify.
I'm not sure we qualify either. Just because we are not nonprofit status.
So
the Strawberry Festival is the 30th
of June.
So my understanding is they usually haul strawberries the 29th
yeah.
that evening. I think they do it all the night before.
But they need help on that day too of volunteer hours as well. If you know any teenagers that need it, because can't they not graduate without the volunteer hours?
They have to
yeah.
have 50.
Yeah.
4 years to 50 hours. That's easy. That's
okay.
awesome though that it's a requirement.
Yeah, definitely.
I like that.
Kathy, would you send back to me that form?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, whenever you please. And so,
which form? The one that I was supposed to do.
No, she has to fill in a simple line.
Can you want to go to this one? Let me pass it off.
I'll pass it off. I just left that.
Okay, that's fine.
I just know if we got. So, Celia, are you going to find out from that, my initial response that is going to qualify. So, I don't know if you can follow up with somebody else
yeah, it,
and
there's
ask.
Contact.
Yeah. So
that we have to get into.
Yeah.
Contact her and I will let her know. Kathy, don't worry about that.
I have to fill that out.
Tell me what you do.
Any other ideas, like if the STEM, if we wanted to change the STEM one, or if another grant becomes available, what activities are you looking for? You can send me a list if you need
to. What are you looking at? I'm looking up the field trip list.
Well, we said teen camp stuff to offset.
Teen campers can go bowling.
Bowl.
Well, maybe you can go that day. Maybe you can take the switch. We got the Wild Kingdom on here as well. And the Children's Museum, where is that?
Was that Dover?
Most of them are quick. It was a kid and it was in Portsmouth.
You
so.
Need to, like, step up your game.
Alright.
Wait, what did you say?
Children's Museum.
For who?
Just as an extra.
For teen? Or your camp rally? Because that's not, it's not really a teen camp place.
That was not going to do anything for them?
No.
Okay. So then, yeah, that would be wrong.
No, that's definitely for young kids.
Kingdom and bowling. For teen. For
yeah.
replacements if needed. What about another hike? Are we doing, how many hikes are we doing this summer?
I think the teens are just doing one.
We're
doing the Portsmouth escape room for the teens.
There's an escape room in Portsmouth?
How much is that one?
It doesn't say, but it says other days and times by request. They're open on the weekends.
Because, yeah, aren't they usually evening too?
They're usually evening, but other days and times by request.
Okay.
Yeah.
That might be kind of neat.
Yeah.
That would be awesome.
It's 12 and over.
And that would be indoor.
Yes.
I'm sorry, were you looking for teen or Raleigh?
Doesn't matter.
I was kind of just reading them off.
That's okay. I got them. Additional activities.
Okay.
Do you put hiking on there by any chance?
You know, you guys could hike the scout lines anytime
mm-hmm.
you wanted.
Yeah,
if,
no.
Like,
mm-hmm.
something comes up.
I'm thinking one of the Wednesdays, all group will be, like,
split up hiking day. But I'm wondering, too, if one of the teen camp days, they get, cut short if they can't go to like Mount Agamenticus and hike it.
Mm-hmm. Some of those kids just did that, so.
Yes.
Oh, we did.
Well,
I
was
you know
just...
you're
So what we need to do, at look at the teen camp to look at, like, what isn't a full day, right?
Yeah, so Blitz technically, financially, will not be a full day.
Yeah.
I don't, and you said take flight would be a full day.
Yes, because we can afford to do the full day because there's no camp on Wednesday. So that's why that's a full day. Yeah.
Hilltop would be the majority of the day. There'd only be like an hour or two to fill.
Okay.
But you could do maybe like an ice cream or something after that.
Right.
But that would probably be including the ice cream.
Oh. Yeah.
Gotcha.
Okay.
Let's see. Water Country is a full day. Candy is a full day. So yeah, it's really just those two. Oh, indoor ascent. I'm not sure if that was a full day or not.
You know, I'm trying to remember what I typed. Yeah, so I did the contact with, his name is Chad, in case you want that.
So,
he's the contact. Let's see if I have.
Blitz, and then what was the other one?
Hilltop.
Okay.
It's only like an hour or two difference for me.
There's a, like, right near Hilltop is, what's the pond over there? They have trails around there, too.
Oh,
Willand
Pond.
Willand.
They have found items around there that we,
really?
I would not.
That's actually not, well, there is Willand Pond, but there's another pond, like, right on that same road. If you go back, there's a Taekwondo place, and then there's a little pond right there.
That
it's right behind Home Depot.
Okay.
So that's where those two meet.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, there's a little pond back there.
Okay.
It's
I did want to tell you that with the indoor ascent, I asked him also if he could kind of be a backup off for a rainy day, and he was pretty okay. Like, he was enthusiastic about that.
Okay.
So he's confirmed for the 6th. That day has been confirmed.
Well, she's looking.
Yeah.
If I can just sneak in, you're thinking teen camp's hours are going to be 9 to 4, like.
That's what I was assuming was correct.
Okay. That's because I put it in one of my grants
that
both camps were 9 to 4.
Yeah.
So I just wanted to confirm.
Yeah, it's really not on here, but I was just assuming it would be that because I know
so
there's a few that also need the pre and post because they're out of town kind of thing. So I was just going on the same line of.
Brittany, can I give you the assignment, indoor ascent, there's a waiver, and we might run into that with, I know Blitz Air Park needs a waiver signed, so if we can get that out.
What was his name again?
Chad.
And was he, are you still looking to see if they're full day or?
Yeah, I was looking to see if he told me. It's about $20 would include all gear and our standard 3-hour time slot. So that would definitely be.
So that would be a half day-ish.
Yeah. So I have us coming in for the 9:30 start on the 6th. So it would be 9:30, 10:30, 11:30, 12:30. So it would be then
after
a break
lunch,
for lunch. Then we need to find something at that point in time.
Are you just wanting to go to the Children's Museum, or?
It was just a list of options of possible backups if needed.
Okay. How many people do you think it's going to be? Last year was 75. Do you think it'll be like 60 this year?
I'm hoping for at least 75 again.
Because I know somebody on the board of directors to the Children's Museum, so it might be like a deeply discounted thing. Yeah, okay, I'll talk to
you. Thank you. Like if it's rainy on a field trip day or something, go there instead. That'd be great.
Yeah. And then there's the pirate park behind there.
Mm-hmm.
They might slip off of it if it's raining, but.
Right.
Yeah.
They'll still make it.
they didn't really. Did they like that last year?
Some did.
Some of the older kids obviously did not. But like the little kids loved it.
Yeah.
So hard getting the older kids to like anything.
Yeah. Better than being stuck in the gym.
Yeah. Smelling you.
And that's why I love the idea of the teen camp, so the kids get more involved. But.
And when I was writing the.
It's also only summer number one. not go through the entire thing. It's just the first summer.
When I was writing the grants for to include the teen camp, I'm like, this is an opportunity to get them out and in the community and away from staying home alone when their families have work commitments.
Yeah.
And off their stupid cell phone.
I didn't put that in there.
You never know. That brings up a good point. Do I let her decide the phone role for them, or do you want me to decide their phone roles?
What did we decide about teen camp? Didn't we have that discussion?
I don't remember about teen camp. I remember regular camp.
Right.
Only pre and post.
Regular camp, I think we were like, oh, pre and post. What did we do about that? No,
if
post?
You were from Raleigh, it was just pre and post to get in contact with your parents.
Okay.
I feel like it's hard with teen only because I know, like, for myself, once I was able to get my phone, my mom was always, like, checking in here and there, just, like, seeing how my day was going.
Mm.
So I feel like that's...
And with certain events, they won't be able to have it on, like,
right.
Indoor and Blitz. Like, they're not
right.
able to have it in their
right.
hands, but...
And then you hate to have anybody lose it or...
Right. That's
stolen
that's
or blah, blah, blah.
Or,
right.
like, me, drop it on the ground and smash it.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Did anybody... so all t-shirts. What do we need to decide about that?
Oh, I have a whole packet right here. Okay,
so I wanted to ask everybody
that one's better.
The t-shirt. Did we? Were you using the same t-shirt that we did last year? Is that true? Yes.
Yes.
For the campers.
Yes.
Camp Raleigh. Yes.
So are we giving everybody out another t-shirt? Or are we kind of just saying? Do you have yours from last year, and do you need another one?
No, it's included in the registration fee.
So we might want to think about that for next year, if we have return campers for the third year, that, you know, I don't know how we would do that budget-wise, but they might not need another shirt next summer. So that might be something to think about. Although, maybe by the end of the summer, they trashed it.
I know some kids need new.
Yeah.
Or they've grown since the last summer, so they need a new shirt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They've gone up a size or
yeah.
something.
I know some.
But I just know it's not like a,
we all
you know.
Need a new shirt.
Mine are fine. I'm
going to
call
So I have, did she send it out to everybody or did she just send it to a few of us?
I don't know. There was a lot of notes about t-shirts.
So,
and I couldn't,
many
so
yeah.
this is what
I did
Celia D.
Have you.
Me, Brittany. Yeah.
Okay. So this is what was the shirt last year on the back for the staff.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They want to know if we're going with the same on the back.
Yeah.
And whether or not we're doing it in the green or we're doing it in white because we're changing shirt colors for the staff, right?
Mm-hmm.
So this is what it would... here. That's
somebody talked about a banana yellow.
That was me. Because originally when I went online, the first link Kristen sent me, there was a banana yellow color
yeah.
option.
So those are the...
those are apparently not according to those.
There's no banana yellow.
There is no yellow in there.
No,
what
there's
color?
Nothing on there. But the link that she had sent me like a month and a half ago had a yellow, which is why I sent that. But I think if you were to do anything, I would go with that one.
Which one?
The lighter
turquoise.
Blue.
Boys
because there's
that.
Not enough of them. There was only one
so
counselor
awesome.
Who was not a fan of the tank tops, so that's why we're just pushing through and going with it. Because he can wear his shirt from last year if he'd like.
He has a choice.
Yeah, I'm not going to force him to wear the tank top every day if he doesn't want to.
He also didn't get back to us for like
yes,
2 weeks after, and we
had
already sent the email in, so.
Snooze, you lose.
Right.
So. You guys tell me whether you want the black or white and circle which one, which color you want, or whatever.
Black or white, what? What are you talking about?
Writing, green or white.
Okay.
And that'll be on the back. And this is what the fronts would look like
mm-hmm.
in the two-tone or the one-tone.
She talked about same green staff on the back like last year.
Yeah.
That's what this is.
Yeah, this one.
Oh, okay.
And that would be the green.
Oh, look, there's the...
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Here, you guys look at that one.
go like the kids, or you could go plain white
just
for you guys.
That gives us more color options for shirts.
And still, yeah, you're good with like the 119 total or a little.
Well, that was a question I had. So, 119 shirts is what you put in on Canva, too.
Yes, it's 119 total for camper shirts for Raleigh.
But does that include what we already have from?
So what I did was I took what Dee had left over, what Sports Engine had given me, and then the numbers that she had sent from what we ordered last year. And I finagled them around.
So
if you want to add more.
I don't think we need to add more. I'm wondering if we're going to have extra.
I'd rather have extra because she said even
last year we put in the
second order more. So I'd rather have extra on
right
this first order than having to reorder.
I mean, we had even had parents buying like three
yeah
right shirts last
and
year.
In July. Because
right
it kept losing their shirts.
Well, that's going to be laundry.
Exactly. With two field trips a week, like that's.
And you're only getting one shirt per child. So if you want extras. So that was one of my questions. So the colors for the staff, and are you choosing for just Camp Raleigh, or is this for Teen Camp too? Will the Teen Camp shirts for the staff be the same
yes
as the campers, or as you?
As, I talked to her about this, and she said she wants to match us, not her kids, because technically she's, you know,
yeah,
them. So.
She's, no.
She said the largest we had to offer, and I was like, so a large or an extra large? I ordered a couple extra larges on here.
There are some,
I'm not sure.
There are some.
She's so tall.
There's some extra. There are 2Xs and 3Xs if we want to.
I just didn't know. I can text her.
So,
or you can text
the XL.
Her.
I think the XL.
I think the XL would be okay. I think the 2X would be too much.
Yeah. So they will say staff on the back for the Teen Camp too?
Yes.
Okay. So,
does our donation cover
the donation?
That's my question.
Last year it was $15.10 with the shirt that you're wearing in the order.
Okay.
So I'm not exactly sure. We put in a purchase order for $1,700 or $1,750. We budgeted $900 for shirts above and beyond. I think t-shirt sales, we put in $185. That's how much people paid last year to buy extra shirts above and beyond that. And then in the Teen Camp budget, we put in a ton of money.
And I don't think we're going to need that, right?
For t-shirts, and
we're just getting plain, right? With
but
now I can't find it.
White, they're just getting white shirts with the CNJ logo on the back.
Yeah, and then
and
when
we were
she
gonna
asked
tie-dye
about the front blank. What do you think?
I'd leave the front blank because we were going to tie dye them.
Yeah.
So if it just had the black logo on the back, I think that works.
Yeah.
So just the black logo.
I would agree with that. Do we need to vote on that?
No. We don't have that. And did you want it to say Raleigh? Like Raleigh above it? Like
for
the Teen Camp?
Just the whatever the CNJ is.
Just the CNJ?
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay, and don't say Raleigh. Okay, and you're going to tell her which color you want, right?
Yeah.
And so my question was looking at your numbers. How many are you giving out to
staff?
Staff.
I said I was counting two for each like we did last summer.
Because we gave three.
We got three?
Yeah.
Oh.
I have three.
You have three?
I have three.
I thought it was just me and Annie that had three.
No, I think
okay
we ended up all taking two at first, and then
right
we had extra, so we did three.
Okay. So, yeah, I don't mind upping those numbers.
So just make them multiples of three.
Yeah. green clover?
Green clover.
You don't like green?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Did you pick?
They're working on it.
Okay.
I
mean, I would say I think those numbers look good, Celia, right? 120 basically camper shirts.
Yeah.
I think that's a good
31 tank tops.
Yeah.
Three times.
Well, those will go up. She's going to change the staff shirts to add three for each camper.
Okay.
I was kind of against the gray, but
okay, so we'll just change her.
Which her?
What I'm wearing.
Great, we did it.
I'm only thinking of this because I know
Sam and the boys.
Yeah,
I agree.
I was thinking gray because of like
gray.
How many different like personalities we have.
Kelly, can you give me that one of those packets? Because I think the only one that's gonna have an issue.
This one is. Which one do I need?
And which color
this
color
one?
You need both of these, technically. But
I know, I'm
just losing my mind.
I don't mind. Do you guys care if that one counselor wears his t-shirts? Because I don't care.
As long as he's wearing a shirt, I don't care.
Okay, that's fair.
I think you should give. Oh, because they're the same color as the counselors, right? I mean, as the campers.
Our t-shirts?
Yeah. Last
yes.
year was.
They're the same, yeah.
I kind of like if you want to wear your t-shirt on a colder day, I don't know.
See, that's what I was planning.
I
had to
talk to
you
about
that. Just because, yeah, that's something that we
can have. Mine has,
yes?
Yeah, it says staff on it. I'm okay with that.
The budget for the team, yeah.
I would say tell her. Brittany, I'd say all the returners, like, you know,
that's
pick one.
Yeah.
So,
I'd like to see it.
We've budgeted three t-shirts per teen camper, so they would have one for each day they came.
I didn't know that. So that's why those numbers are so low. Okay, I can change those.
I will forward you guys the budget. And
so more than one tie-dye? Is that what you're saying to me?
Yeah.
Well,
you
don't tie-dye? It's a lot of tie-dye.
And my question...
I'm sarcastic.
No, I'm just saying to myself.
I think two tie-dye. I
don't know. Two shirts?
Well, I'm also thinking, so we need to think about that a little bit in that, you know, for the teen camp, they're only coming 3 days, first of all. Some of these kids might only sign up for 2 weeks. So, you know, if we look at the population that could be, right, we're looking at 15 to 20 kids per week, but that... It might be 100 kids total, so we have to kind of, right? Right.
Wait.
Well,
so
how many teachers we give for?
The staff are getting three.
No, but I know, but we give Camp Raleigh kids one t-shirt, right?
And then they have to pay for the other one.
If they want one. Right.
Yeah.
I am favor one.
People are going to do laundry. I mean.
No matter
yeah.
what,
that's too many shirts.
Yeah.
Three.
Yeah.
Yeah. So go down to
two. I was
thinking
one. Just one.
Yeah.
Same as the other.
Okay. So then that's right.
Okay. So my other question was, what about the teen camper? When are they doing the tie dye? Are they doing it the first day?
Doing it before.
Okay. So you're going to do
what?
That was my question. So has it been since five, and they are not there the first?
No, if you wish, shirts are getting dyed as soon as I get them. That way they can have them for day one.
So
and if you can help me with that, I'll do it myself.
No,
I can help you, but I don't know.
So I don't know.
That was
a
suggestion.
We should do like 50. How many did you have on there listed? You said 38.
But if you want
to, I don't know.
This is the first time I've ever done a shirt order. I have no idea what I'm doing.
Well,
I'm winning all of this.
It's hard for us to do this order.
And she said if they're white shirts with black lettering, they're going to be more cost efficient than the colored shirts with the colored eggs.
So,
right.
So it won't be difficult to order more?
I would say let's go with 50.
Yeah.
And then
I would definitely add to your extra small.
Yeah. For teen?
Yeah, for teen.
Because
that's
still,
I don't
that's
even know.
The same as
I don't even
extra large.
And Brittany, honestly, I don't even know if I would go youth medium for that. Do you think?
There's one.
Really?
Yep. Which is why I had that,
okay.
Just in case.
And yeah, I mean, you want a couple extra in case you have a couple really thin framed girls or small.
Right. And that's
girls.
I know for a fact that's what one of them is. So.
Okay.
That's the only reason I was there. Yeah, because it's the same as a.
Because
there is no extra large.
Right.
I would up that one.
To
I would,
six
yeah,
or
the
eight.
Adult extra small, I think I'd go
yeah.
more on.
Yep. Okay. So
and adult, an adult
small,
probably.
A couple mediums. Yep.
Yeah, I would do like eight of the extra small and then 10 of the smaller mediums.
Mm-hmm.
And that will give you four, another eight. So that brings you up to 46. And then you could pick the other ones. And then, yeah.
Am I offering these Raleigh shirts, or are we, do we, I
think
that's pretty decent.
I think you're pretty decent.
19.
And then we have what Dee has at her
and
house.
There's like 45 at Dee's house total. So.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
And I'm glad to see that the kids extra small are
okay.
kind of low, because those would be your first graders. Yeah. On the kids.
Yeah, no, she has a bunch of extras, which is why that number's low, but I can add a couple.
No. Keep it where it is.
Okay.
That's a good number for
okay.
that size.
That's what I was thinking.
Because if you read the tag, that's ages 4 to 5.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, unless you get some small kids.
I'm glad that mediums are bumped up this year.
And the only, I would say adult extra small if you feel like you need more, but
yeah,
that would be
too.
On the camper shirts. But that, okay. So do you have other stuff on your agenda?
I have nothing.
I have one thing. We said in May we would talk about financial aid, and we have three donations for sponsorships. We've not publicized that we have three Camp Raleigh sponsorships. Somebody could go to Camp Raleigh for all 8 weeks for no charge. Are we publicizing that? When and how?
What did we do? Do we do anything with that last year? We did not make that public, correct?
We did it the end of May, beginning of June. And we.
So is that something we should put on the Facebook page for financial aid? Let me talk to Dee about that on Wednesday, and I'll see what she thinks.
And you might want to include Jody on it. That,
yeah.
Because
she was in charge of that pretty much, right?
Yeah. And my thought was, if since we have the funds, that probably get more people coming through asking for financial aid, and do they partial pay, or do we use it towards teen camp? Because I think the three of them we got were for $330, which would be 3 weeks of teen camp for residents.
True.
And then that would mean some teenager who may not be able to go might be able to go to teen camp. So maybe we publicize it and look at where we go. Do we go all three to Camp Raleigh, or do we go one to the team?
Or do we just kind of look at the people who
apply?
Uh-huh.
And if we don't get, do we give partial assistance to some people if they don't meet, if nobody meets the requirement? We had people meet the requirement last year.
Right. I don't think we need to worry about that.
I think if you do partial, the people that gave the money, I guess once they give it, they don't have any control over it. However, it was given in the spirit of, I know the one from the ladies auxiliary was given in the spirit of, there's a kid that's going to be sitting on the couch, that can't afford to go to camp, and they're going to be able to go to the camp for the whole 8 weeks. So I would say.
So were you thinking they were,
They were thinking
one kid.
Camp Raleigh.
Camp Raleigh?
Yes.
Okay.
So I'm just giving, I'm just throwing that out there, because if they come back and ask, I mean, I'm separate in both places. I don't talk about what happens here or there, or vice versa.
Yeah.
But I know that the spirit and the intent of that money given was, I'm sorry, now it's on. that I'm just saying, you know, the spirit and the intent of that money was to get somebody off the couch for the 8 weeks.
Yeah.
Probably. So. You have to look at the donating.
Right. Well, and that might be interesting. Maybe. Maybe we should go back and ask that question to the other two. Right.
Well, I know one representative is here from one of the other organizations.
Yeah.
And I'm guessing that the third donor had the same spirit in mind.
Okay.
That would be that they would like to see the kids actively engaged in the summer instead of staying at home or getting into trouble in the community.
Okay, so but would that be a team?
Yeah. It could be a team.
Yeah. And yours could be, maybe?
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of good to know.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know how we go about that. That's a good question. So maybe I'll engage Dee and Jody about that. And you said last year we did at the end of May, did we put it somewhere? Did we put it out there somewhere?
I will look.
I don't remember it being out there.
I don't remember.
I think we had people inquire, so it's kind of interesting that nobody has asked about this summer yet. But then I really still kind of feel come that June 15th time, crying, and they're like,
right,
oh yeah,
right.
I should ask soon.
Yeah.
Oh yeah,
but
I should sign up soon.
Can I just say, at least that gives us, like, I like the fact that there's a date of cutoff and that we're going to follow it this year.
Yes.
Is that even if you have people show up on that day being like, oh, wait, I forgot, you know, you at least have a few days to figure out.
Right.
What I like.
So, when should we meet again?
Oh no, I'm going to amend one of the grants. So if I can just copy that information, I will give it back to you.
This was,
I'm going to add it into the Newberry report.
You might want to give that to Brittany.
Quarterly?
Yeah, why don't you contact him, Brittany? Why don't you contact him and just ask him if he has any available dates for the summer?
I know you're trying to copy it too, so I don't want to move it.
Available dates and maybe just let them know that we're kind of waiting on grant money, but we, you know, are thinking of having him. And I don't know if it's all booked up for the summer or not. You know, it might be nice to see if he has.
I know at this point last year he kind of was.
Was he really?
Yeah, that was part of the issue. It wasn't just money last year.
Wow.
He booked up pretty quick.
All right.
So yeah, ask about availability and his current pricing. If it or not.
Yeah.
Would you be, I know this is kind of like, it's educational, but would you be open to a tour of something on the shipyard, like one of the shops?
Yeah.
Yeah, because that's free, and it gets you out, and it's like a half-day tour.
Yeah, if we can figure out the money for the transportation.
Well, that's,
that's
a problem.
It,
so it's
a half,
transportation.
It's the bus fee, but
yeah.
I would love that if we can find a way for the bus fee to work without having to ask for it.
This is when we need a transportation grant.
You wrote yourself down?
I know. And one of the things on my list was, does anybody have any other ideas on, like, activities or events that we could pass on?
I'm old. And that's Roxford's fun day thing. But they want us to have a vision to make.
What else? Cousin.
Right. I wasn't going to worry you that this,
yes,
you'll be back at school at that time.
Brittany, can I have your email?
Yes.
I know I'm probably have it somewhere, but I'm just going to write it down again.
I'm going to give you the director email. rec, or it's weird.
It's okay.
R E R. Right? No. R E C. Sorry. E I R. At Rollinsford.nh.us.
Okay, I'm going to reach out to that lady.
Yeah.
And just
send her my way.
See how many times she
well,
can come.
What did we do? What did we do about the Woodman Park? Because that was extra money.
We got a, we used, that was a grant, that was a donation.
Okay.
And I thought we had gone.
Mm-hmm.
And I sent the donation.
I thought we did too.
We ended up going to Henry Golf Park.
Oh, okay.
And that donor, I did talk to back in March. I have not talked to her since about donating money. But I know last year when we talked to that donor, she was really into bringing in an animal show.
Right.
So if
the Sea Coast can come.
She took information. I have not seen anything come up yet. So hopefully, I believe I have her email, and I can reach out to her. And if the grant doesn't come through for the Sea Coast Science Center, maybe we can get them to come in. Or the, what's the other one, Mount Washington Observatory or
mm-hmm.
something like that.
What would they do? It's coming along, you know, about that already.
Washington?
Yeah.
It's about weather and, like, lightning, and then there's one about weather at the top of Mount Washington. And there's a third one that you got. I put it on the drive today.
I haven't figured out that drive thing yet in my 2 years of doing this. What are we thinking going forward here with the next meeting?
What about the week? 2 weeks? That's what I'm thinking. The week. Is it
2 weeks?
Second?
Is the third. 2 weeks is the third. 3 weeks is the tenth.
I would say the third or the
tenth.
We're
training. So.
Oh. So
I don't know.
The third? How about we do the third? So training is, what time is your training up there?
We got to talk about time.
Okay.
Because I got to finish.
Is everybody okay with the third?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Seven. Same thing.
Yeah.
Testing.
And then maybe if we need to meet one more time, we can meet the 24th or something, cause, or during the week, because that next Sunday.
That Monday is.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And then the weekend of the 17th is Father's Day.
Mm-hmm.
I'd rather not meet that weekend.
Yeah, also
every day is Father's Day.
Very true.
Caroline, we're going to have to get a a check.
Might have to do it every week.
I believe so. Oh, you know what?
Because
let me ask the pool director if he's okay with doing like three or four, right?
Yeah.
Maybe do two for the summer. I'll ask him that. I did confirm Friday with him just a couple weeks ago. I just said, hey, just want to make sure that Fridays are still our day. And he's like, yep. And he's still charging us the same amount, which is
$3.
Yep.
So the select board likes to know how we're spending our money, usually before it goes out the door. So what I would suggest is for you to maybe do a purchase order ahead of time for like the first few weeks, for like up to like $600, and then you, or whatever it is, or whatever you think is an appropriate amount, the select board can okay it, and then when you get when the invoice comes in, they can pay it out.
Let me write that on my list. Let me have a conversation with Caroline in the office and ask her how she wants us to.
That would be the best way
to go, I think. Okay. I'll just see what she. Okay, I want to give Kathy something.
I have a question. I don't know if it'll apply to you guys, but for counselors, are we doing paid training days again?
And we counted that as like one full day, and we broke it up into 2 4-hour blocks, right?
So how we did that last year within our budget was there were 2 days of the 4th of July that we counted then as training days.
Mm-hmm.
So this year, what do we have in our, I know one of those days, the 4th, would be
overlapped.
Right, so that would count. So Celia, what else did we add in there?
$8. Oh, just a second.
I think you have to go paid training.
I just didn't remember if it was like a full day or a half day.
Well, and then also if we're doing, like, say we do June 23rd as setup day, is that also considered a training day, or is that considered a, we really hope you can come, please join us?
I think we paid you last year, but
I don't remember if we did.
Yes, but that was because we had broken up the training a certain way, which is what I'm asking. Days, a day and a half.
So we budgeted $610 for training for the staff. That does not include the director and assistant directors. That's just for the hourly staff.
So that would be 10 of them. Right? Is there 10? So that would be 6 hours for, essentially 6 hours for the second. So it's a full day. So it's a full day for the whole.
For the
4th.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then you get another 6 hours.
Okay, so we have like a day and 3 4.
Yeah, almost 2 days. Because there's 7 hours a day.
Yeah.
And don't forget you have to add in your CPR first day.
Yeah, that's 2 hours.
So you could have them come.
So then we could do, I don't know why I was working out, we could have gotten that stuff done 4 hours. So, Sunday. We had 2 nights.
Right, yeah.
That was really repetitive. So it could be all squished into that one Sunday for like 5 hours.
Well, and I think with your staff is mostly
returners.
So you're not going to have that same type of training.
Right.
So
it's going to be, so Sunday could be like 4 or 5 hours, 2 hours on
the
CPR, so it's the 6 hours, and then the setup day could be the full day.
I'm wondering, last year, did you guys get the parent handbook last year? Did you get it late?
I got it very late.
Do we have a copy of the parent handbook now that you use
it? Has it been updated?
I don't have an updated copy.
I don't know if that's been updated.
Okay.
So
does it need to have others? Does it need to be updated?
I think there was like a few little things that we added.
Did you judge a D about that?
I thought I had at the end of last summer, so I don't know what happened.
Okay, let me ask.
I know she updated the pizza prices. We had a whole discussion about that.
And that's only every other week.
And Because you should have that at your training, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
And if you guys can move it now, didn't know.
Right. Yes. My big thing about that one was the sunscreen, which I think we talked about in the fix, but I can't remember.
Okay.
Right.
What did we fix?
My question was in there, I thought it said that if they arrive without an adult,
if
they have to sit until an adult is notified that they arrived late. I didn't know if that was.
All right, anything else?
This is last year's that you need.
It was last year's, right?
It might be a good basis if you don't
yeah.
mind giving
yeah.
it up.
Thank you.
I think mine is still on that clipboard.
That was
okay.
Email.
That was email. It wasn't printed out and given to people.
Yeah. No,
I
have one.
I have it on the drive.
Good. We'll see you. We'll be here
just send everything.
2 weeks.